on a journey to achieve something great in life? Are you on a journey to achieve the unachievable, to achieve that which nobody has yet achieved around you before? Then you need to take a bold step. Because in every step you take, in every decision, everything that you want to do, you must take a bold step and fight, because there are contentments against everything that you want to do. Whatever you want to do, there are battles you must battle, there are wars you must fight before you can achieve that which you must achieve. Do you know that the Bible says in the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence and the violence take it by force. He said, and then there was war that was broke up in heaven, that the great enemy called Satan was fighting for the things of the kingdom of God. And since he does not belong to that kingdom because of the contentment, he must be sacked, he must be removed to come on this earth. And behold, the word said, be warned unto you, the descendants or the descendants of the earth, because you are going to fight great fights. Let's move direct to our topic today about fighting against the principalities of our marriage life. Today, I want to advise and I want us to talk about the fights we fight when it comes to our marriage life. It is very important we take steps to fight against our marriage. Are you already married? If you are already married, please don't go away. Stay tuned, because this message will help you. If you are on a journey to get married, don't go away. Stay tuned, because this message will help you. And it will help me as well, because we are all on a missionary fight. Good. Marriage is the biggest aspect of life. Even if we are selecting all things to prosper, marriage is the biggest aspect of life that the enemy fights against most importantly. Because in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter number 4, the Bible says that two are always better than one. And it continues to say that. It said a cord of three is not easily broken. So why is the enemy fighting against that thing that is called godly marriage? I say godly because he will not fight against that marriage that belongs to his kingdom. He is always fighting for the godly marriage, because he knows if you are a godly being and you marry a godly woman and you give birth to a godly child, what will happen? You become a cord of three that cannot be broken. So there is always a fight to fight. Remember, I said in the beginning, war broke up in heaven. So it means there is fight. The fightings against good things in our life started from the days of old. Fightings against good things that belong to us didn't start from today. It started from the generations far behind us. So I want us to fight a fight. And do you know the fight we are going to fight is, we are not going to use gun, we are not going to use knife or any other equipment, but we are going to use the fight of prayer. The fight of prayer is that when you are about, or when you are on a mission, you are on a journey to have access to your marital home, there are fights and contentions you must contend for what belongs to you. Because if you don't contend for what belongs to you, the enemy will replace it with something that you don't want. There is something called anti-marriages. And these anti-marriages that the enemy will bring to your life, some of these anti-marriages are having desire for things that doesn't belong to the kingdom of God. Let's say womanizing can be an anti-marriage that the enemy can give unto you. Lesbianism and gayism can be an anti-marriage that the enemy will give to you, that you have so much desire in it that you don't want to give up on them. Masturbation can be an anti-marriage that the enemy wants to give to you so that you don't give up on, because when you become addicted to these things, it is difficult to give up. I want you to take a very crucial look when it comes to the aspect of marriage. Because there are things you must fight. If you don't fight for what belongs to you, the enemy will always give you the fake one. So, prayer is the only thing that the enemy, that can make the enemy away. If you want to achieve the unachievable, if you want to enjoy that sweetness in your marriage, if you want to achieve that which nobody has enjoyed before in the area called marriage. You know, marriage is the biggest area. I already said that the enemy fights against. Why? Because the Bible knows, because the enemy knows that when you become two and eventually you become three, he cannot chase you. So today that you're on a mission to marry, today that you're on a mission to get your marital home set up, the enemy wants to bring anti-marriage materials to your way if you don't pray. There is always a saying that however you lay your bed is how you sleep on it. If you don't pray for that which you want to achieve, you will get that which you don't want. So you must better start praying now and bind up principality, bind up anti-marriage things that the enemy will use to fight against your life. You know, there is always a way that the enemy will package something nicely to give you, but after giving it to you, he will definitely request greater than what even he has given to you. There is always in the kingdom of God that you get everything free of charge once you ask for it. You must pray for that which you want. Prayer is a crucial weapon that fights against principalities, things in hidden places that we cannot see, our eyes cannot see, our ears cannot hear. Marriage is not always about sex. Marriage is not always about just enjoying the things around you. But behind in the kingdom of darkness, there are things that are fighting against the goodies of your life, and you must stand firm to fight and contend for that which you want. If you want a happy home, if you want to have a peaceful marriage, then you must start setting your grounds now as a young guy, as a young lady. You must pray for that which you want. Are you enjoying your marriage home if you are already married? If you are not enjoying it, it means you have not set up the standard that you need to set up to fight to clear the way to enjoy that happy marriage, that happy life that you want. That is why you are not enjoying what you expected to enjoy, because you have not set the standard right. But yet, I'm coming to advise you that it is not too late. There's always things that you pray about. Even if you pray about it late, things can change up. So if you are not enjoying that which you want to enjoy in your marriage, please start now to fight against that which the enemy has used to replace what you wanted. Today, I want you to take a crucial look that there is only the word or the voice of violence that the enemy listens to. If you don't take that which belongs to you by violence, you cannot attain it. So, it is not too late. If you are already married and you are not enjoying that which you want in your marriage, please start now. Set your standards, set your foundations on that which you want. Set your standards on the word of God with the powerful weapons of prayer, that the enemy which is fighting against the good things of your life will not succeed. Stay blessed. I love you for staying through the message. Please, it is a crucial thing we need to do. If you are about finding someone for your life to marry, to set up your marital home, because you are becoming two, the enemy will always battle against you whilst you are single. Whilst you are single, that is the time for you to embark on powerful prayer points. Whilst you are single as a young lady, as a young guy, that is the time you need to back up yourself with words of prayer so that you get that which you want. Thank you for listening. Don't forget to like if you enjoy this message and click on the subscription to enjoy more of such messages coming to your way. My name is Brother Sally, and today is the date 23rd of May 2020. And I want to take this opportunity to wish all my Muslim brothers a happy Eid Mubarak. Thank you all. Bye-bye. Stay tuned.